Hello and welcome to a very special episode of Storyboard. This is a Martech Marathon special brought to us by Netcore and CNBC TV 18 together. What we're trying to do is put together a day-long understanding of changes in marketing caused by technology. This will see 25 speakers speaking 12 minutes each, and they will try and tell you stories of the use of technology by brands and kind of humanize it. Today, to kick off this, we've got Veer from Netcore, and we have Amin Lakhani from Mindshare, and you'll get a glimpse of what you might see at the event. Veer, thank you. Amin, thank you.
Thank you so much.
So, Amin, I thought a lot before calling you to this event.
Really?
Because, you know, when you hear technology, you automatically say it's large capex, and therefore it's appropriate only for, say, high unit price items and so on. While you're using tech in your business with products that like soap and toothpaste and shampoo. So tell me, what are the applications of tech that you're working on?
So basically, three large applications if you talk about Martech. One is, the first bucket is about inciting.
Right.
The second bucket is about targeting. And the third bucket is about engaging. So with technology being so intrinsic today in the consumer's life, you don't have a choice but to adopt it and to get ahead of the curve as soon as is possible. And there's so much of footprint that inciting really is so critical. And we've kind of, our initial working has really led to very interesting learnings about the consumer journey. About their habits, about their patterns, about what they think, about their behaviors, and many such aspects. And that leads to very many innovative ways of targeting them. That leads to many ways of engaging with them.
Right.
So that bucket, very, very critical, very important,
bucket.
The insights part of it. Of course, with the smartphone penetration, or rather the mobile phone penetration being at the levels that it is, there are smarter ways of understanding what is whether to target or not to target. I mean, that's the debate. Some people are of the opinion that the more wider you go, the better it is for a brand to grow. But some people feel that there's wastage as well. So I think that debate will continue. But today, technology gives you that choice.
Right.
And all brands have that choice, whether to smart target or whether you want to go and reach out to consumers widely. And the other part is very important, that given the kind of time spent with technology that a normal consumer has today, we really need to innovate and invent in the ways that we can engage with consumers. The theory is very, very clear that we are at a place, because what we did went right. But moving forward, the way the industry is moving, I don't think if we continue to do that and don't change, we might just lose out.
Right. I'll come back to you, Amin, and I'll ask you to share a few sort of examples with brand stories. Now, Veer, one of the big challenges now is globally, not just in India, is GDPR, and a lot of what Amin is talking about requires a lot of access to and use of a lot of data. So there's a whole issue of privacy versus profitability as a sort of conflicting choice that you make. So tell me, in your business too, privacy becomes a large part. So how do brands navigate that privacy part?
Anand, one of the biggest enablers of this age is the device and the data that goes with it. So
right.
When you're talking about GDPR, the digital footprint that the customer leaves behind on digital properties is what it is trying to regulate. So whenever an industry matures, regulation comes in, right? I mean, till the industry is nascent, nobody really bothers about it,
right.
How important it is or how relevant it is. So now you can, a sign of GDPR basically coming in is that this industry is maturing. People are now worrying about that, what is happening to customer data. So GDPR is all about the power going back to the customer. In fact, the whole digital age is about the shift of power balance to the customer, vis-a-vis the brand. So GDPR is trying to say that, the customer is in control of his data. Now, whether the customer really gets into the granularity and controls this data, we will see. But at least he will have the power to do so.
He or she.
He or she will have the power to do so. as far as the brand is concerned, I think eventually it will make it easier for the brand to define the governance and, you know, what is legally possible or not possible.
No, this is interesting. You're bringing the word governance into an area of marketing, which you never heard. You go back 10 years, what is governance and marketing? There are two different governance. You know, the board had to worry about. Marketing people didn't worry about. Today you have to.
Yes, and that is because, you know, the whole change is the digital footprint and the data that the customer is leaving behind. And the marketer today, we talk about data-driven marketing. The recent Melt conference, speaker said it's not, but don't be data blinded. So we are hearing all sorts of things around the data. But I think it is in essence, it's all about relevance. Because the part about digital marketing is the cost of digital messaging is comparatively low, you know, vis-a-vis the other mediums. So when the cost of a message is low, there's abundance of that. And I think that is where, you know, relevance comes in. And data is really a way to make sure that your messaging is relevant to the customer. And I think that is where when the data comes in, it is about the customer and an individual customer. Because till now we were dealing with segments of customer and groups of customer. And that's another big change. So that is where I think governance and GDPR, all this really becomes important.
Right. Wonderfully brought that up. You know, you look at the strength of media planning. It is being able to target large groups of customers, the historic strength. Right. Large groups of customers in a homogeneous sets of customers efficiently, more efficiently than somebody else. I mean, that's what got you your business. Now, suddenly we're talking about micro-targeting to a point of personalized targeting.
Right.
So how does it change the way you work with the marketer, the questions the marketer asks you?
When you ask me, and earlier you also asked me about a couple of examples, and one other thing that this entire opportunity is enabling, is unlocking, is the power, to empower our consumers. You know, this entire empowerment journey has been very fulfilling, and I can think of two companies right now, and I'm just remembering them as to how they've kind of empowering. One of them is, of course, in a larger group, Colgate is a client, and they did an initiative called Pocket Dentist, wherein they kind of used the feature phone technology to reach out to consumers in the rural heartlands, and where perhaps access to a regular specialist dentist wasn't available.
Right.
And how they used a basic phone technology to enable those consumers to reach out for any support or guidance or help in their dental hygiene issues, and it's been received so fantastically. You've kind of spread the benefit of expertise to lands which perhaps 5-7 years, maybe 10 years back was unheard of.
Right.
So that's the first one that comes to my mind. The second one that comes to my mind is about Lifebuoy.
Right.
They recently did a campaign in partnership with SocioCops, which is a big data partner. And what they actually enabled is that Lifebuoy understood that there are these villages where in the last fortnight there's incidence of communicable diseases which is coming up. And which is as real time that it can get.
Right.
So within a fortnight, they could send out messages to those villages, people in those villages, that diarrhea is happening. One of the very basic things that you can follow is wash your hands daily.
Right.
With Lifebuoy. So I'm just saying that from reaching to enabling to empowering, I think it's a fabulous journey, and this I think is just the tip of the iceberg. And going forward, there is, some hajar opportunities available.
Right. With that, we'll take a short break. And when we come back, we'll stay with Amin and talk about the use of the phone, not just smartphone as the underlining. A lot of what he's doing is with the non-smartphone, with text-based messaging and text-based targeting. So we'll be back in a bit.